Hello everyone, in this video we'll be seeing about the various types of weldings that are done in a welding, various methods that are done in a welding. So one is a TIG welding, MIG welding and an oxyacetylene welding. So these are the three types of weldings that we are going to see in this video. So first one is a TIG welding. So TIG welding, it is expanded as tungsten inert gas welding, which is also known as gas tungsten arc welding, is an arc welding method. This is a type of arc welding which uses a non-consumable tungsten electrode. So we saw in the previous video there are two types of electrodes. One is consumable electrode and the other one is non-consumable electrode. So here we, in the TIG welding, we are using a non-consumable electrode to weld two or more work pieces. It is a very much similar to that of a metal inert gas welding. So these two are types of arc welding. One is a tungsten inert gas TIG welding and the metal inert gas MIG welding. The following components are necessary to perform tungsten inert gas welding. One is a power supply, it may be an AC supply or a DC, non-consumable tungsten electrode, inert gas supply, filler rod depending upon the nature of workpiece, and a welding head. So this is the arrangement of a tungsten inert gas. So if we are using a non-consumable electrode, there is an electrode holder and a welding gun which is connected to a inert gas, and one end is connected to the power supply and the one more end is connected to the inert gas supply. So in this electrode holder, the inert gas is also sent, which provides the gaseous shield in order to prevent the chemical reaction that takes place in the surface, and the workpiece is connected to one end of the power source. So when the power supply is switched on, the electrode holder, it is brought near the workpiece and maintained a gap. So usually arc welding means we are bringing the electrode holder near the workpiece, but with a gap of 1.5 mm to 3 mm. Here we are having a inert gas supply. Inert gas supply, it doesn't react with the atmosphere. In order to prevent the surface of the workpiece, we are using this inert gas, which is also sent inside the electrode holder. So this is how the tungsten inert gas welding is done, and the advantages are it produces a high quality welds. The weld is automatically prevented because of the inert gas, and no slag is produced. TIG welding can be done in any position. So if you take about the disadvantages, it is a slow process and highly skilled labor is required, and it is exposed to high intensity of light, and it is more expensive compared to that of the another type of arc welding, that is MIG welding. And if you take about the applications, it is used for doing welding in stainless steel, alloy steel, aluminium, titanium and copper. So the next is the metal inert gas welding, which is also known as gas metal arc welding, is an arc welding technique in which consumable electrode is used. So previously we, in a tungsten inert gas welding, we used a non-consumable electrode. Here we are using a consumable electrode. So the parts that are required are a consumable electrode, inert gas supply, welding head, AC or a DC power supply, and a electrode feeding mechanism. Since we are using a consumable electrode, the electrode has to be continuously fed with the help of a mechanism. So this is an arrangement of a metal inert gas welding. There is a workpiece which is connected to a power supply, and an electrode holder which is connected to one more power supply, one more end of the power supply. Here you can see a roller in between which the electrode is sent, because it should be supplied continuously. We cannot hold it with the hand, so there should be some mechanism to feed the electrode continuously to the workpiece. So in order to provide a continuous supply to the welding process, the transport rolls are used, which will be rotating in an opposite direction, which makes the electrode to move towards the workpiece. And it is kept in a gaseous shield, in order to prevent the oxidation that takes place in the surface of the workpiece. So this working is also similar to that of the arc welding, where the gap is maintained between the holder is brought near the electrode, the workpiece, and a gap is maintained between the electrode holder and the workpiece, and in which helps in creating the arc. The arc, it makes the electrode to get melted, and it provides a joint between the workpieces. So this is how the MIG welding is done. So the advantages of MIG welding are, it is easy to feed, and no filler rod is needed because we are using a consumable electrode. Welding is simple, and inert gas shield protects the weld automatically. So if you take about the disadvantages, floating of a solid impurities over the liquid weld, if not handled, it become porous, hazardous to nature, and care must be taken to avoid the formation of less ductile welds, and workpiece and electrode should be kept clean before welding. Here is a video of how the TIG and MIG welding is done. So this is the arrangement. First, they are starting with the TIG welding. There is a power supply and inert gas supply, which workpiece is connected to one more end. So the inert gas supply is turned on, and the power supply is also given. So when here, since it is a non-consumable electrode, we are using a separate filler rod. This is a filler rod, and only the arc is produced from this electrode holder. So this is how the welding is done. And the next one is MIG welding. So in MIG welding, we are using a consumable electrodes, so we don't want a separate filler rod. The arrangement is similar to that, except the one more wire spool, where from this the electrode is continuously fed inside the electrode holder. So this gaseous shield is to prevent the surface of the workpiece. Since it's a consumable electrode, it doesn't need any separate filler rod. So this is how the TIG and MIG welding is done. Next one is the oxyacetylene welding. So here both oxygen and acetylene are supplied to do the welding process. So that is the oxyacetylene. So there are different combinations used. So one of the commonly used combination is the oxygen and acetylene welding. So metals are joined in many different ways. Gas welding is one of the most common, most important, because of its scope of application. So the reason why the gas technique has a great fanfare is because of the low cost nature. Carrying out the welding process is very simple, and it can be operated at a temperature of 3100 degrees Celsius. So the components required are a fuel cylinder, oxygen cylinder, control valve, mixture chamber, and a welding torch. So control valve is to control the supply of the oxygen and the acetylene. The use of dual oxygen and acetylene gases stored under a pressure in a steel cylinders. Its ability to switch quickly to a cutting process by changing the welding tips to a cutting tip, and the high temperature gas mixture at times. So this is the arrangement. There is a separate oxygen and acetylene cylinder, which is combinedly sent to a torch, and there is a separate filler rod. Since it's a type, we are not using any consumable electrodes here, so we are having a separate filler rod. And these are some of the types of flames that are obtained during the oxyacetylene welding. It may be a carburizing flame, or a neutral flame, or a oxidizing flame. So this is based upon the supply of the oxygen and acetylene. So if the acetylene is supplied more, then we get a carburizing flame, and if the oxygen is supplied more, oxidizing flame, and if it is both are supplied in an equal way, a neutral flame is obtained. So here is a video of a oxyacetylene welding. So this is the arrangement of an oxyacetylene welding. So this is how the oxygen cylinder, the pressure valve, both are combined and sent, and the welding is done. So this is about the this is about the types of welding, the MIG welding, TIG welding and the oxyacetylene welding. Thank you.